for overall this preparation. And this economy just lies is a very important part of this prelims preparation. And this is also an important one for the mains. Hello, friends. This is Mohammad Sahbaz Khan. Today, we will discuss the economy. Economy, this is class is for the orientation, exactly what economy as a paper, as a subject offers you in this scheme of examination. Because this economy is also a very dominant in a prelims. The question asks in a prelim, in fact, major portions, economy. If you say, if I say in the last, in fact, this year of prelims, almost 14 questions have been asked from the prelims section, from this economy section. Okay. And also, in this scheme of UPSC syllabus, GS1, GS2, GS3, so with this UPSC syllabus, this economy comes into this GS3rd. It comes into the GS3rd of the main syllabus of UPSC. Fine. So, first of all, we have to see this economy. What is the tone and temperament of this question? As we know this, we have seen, as you have seen this analysis, this whole UPSC paper. The UPSC paper, most of this, like most of this part, they are mostly of social sciences. Okay, here you studies this Indian society, geography, economics, quality, ethics. Okay, these all are social sciences in nature, and most of them are humanities. Right? So, what is the main problem with this whole paper? The syllabus, that most of the topics are of humanities or social sciences. So these social sciences or the humanities have the issue with the subjectivity. There are lots of subjectivities attached to this idea of social science. For example, if a democracy, there are multiple definitions of the democracy. Fine, there could be multiple ways of it. So this become difficult for the students many of this time to find the objectivity in this paper. Okay, so this, if I say, relatively, this economic paper, this economy, gives a certain kind of predictability or a certain kind of what this is basically based on this concept and principle. This economy is all about this concept and the principles. But this economy exactly, for say this, you have to prepare only this class notes, class lectures and class notes and current affairs. That is sufficient to prepare for this paper. Fine. So we have a students. So guys, this offer Indian economy is a subject where the less effort or can put you the maximum marks. Okay, not you have to do every time, you have to do main of this analysis, just the concept and this principle. If you have good hand on this concept and principle, this economy is very much easier for you. For your kind information, last year for this year prelims, almost 14 questions, and if you analysis all over the areas, so a good number of questions has been asked directly from this Indian economy. And this Indian economy is mostly of objective in nature. This all mostly involves this concept and principles. So this concept and principle a bit of complex many of the times, but when you have understood this concept, this become easier to prepare for this examination. And here there's a less chances of error as comparison with other topics of the syllabus. Okay, fine. So this today I'll discuss this different syllabus. Okay, the syllabus of this paper. So this exactly chapter one, if I say, there are certain, I have divided this syllabus into many of the subtopics in the topics. So I'll give you the idea ki how this syllabus of the economy is all about. Okay, what topics or the subtopics you have to study under this. Okay, fine. So this very much is first, very much for the first chapter is issue related to planning. Okay, here we'll study the issue of planning. As we have seen before independence, India was ruled by the British. So India managed this economic affairs of the India. This British managed this economic affairs of the India. But their policy, or this colonial policy, mostly based on this idea of maintaining law and order and extraction of the wealth in the name of drain of wealth from the Indian society. So they give very less emphasis to develop Indian economy. So this economy, in fact, which British has perpetuated exactly, it made Indian economy as a feeder economy to the home country, to the England. Here, India was reduced mere as a supplier of raw material and other agriculture commodities, the supplier of agriculture commodity and the overall the net importer of finished goods, or the market for a finished goods for the British made goods. So this self-sufficiency aspect of the Indian economy has been compromised under the British era. In fact, they haven't developed these sectors, they haven't put any kind of effort to develop this different sector of the economy. For example, primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Fine. And because of this, what happened just on the eve of independence, India was having a very challenging job to develop its economy, as we had nothing in terms of economic resources to get our economy further in the path of development. The poverty was very much high. Okay, so in order to curtail this, as we have seen in the national movement, there is a tinge of the socialism, or this whole process involved this socialist tendency in offering economic development. So again, India, after independence, after British, to manage this issue of rising poverty and dependent nature of Indian economy, India adopted the model of mixed economy. From here, it started the era of planning. This has been done by forming or establishing planning commission in India. Okay, and this was starting with this planning era. So we will discuss in this chapter all is about this planning. What is exactly the planning means? What are the different types of planning? How this planning exactly leads to the development? And also all those five-year plan. It started the era of five-year plan. So what is this five-year plan? What is different goals of this each five-year plan? Is what fail or not? This whole evaluation of this planning till 1991, we will discuss. And also how many types of this different model. Okay, so we will study in this whole planning chapter. Fine. Again, the next chapter will discuss this growth and development. So this growth and development in this chapters will discuss the economic growth in India. Okay, so this economic growth, because the whole purpose of this planning was what? To make Indian economy grow. Fine. So that our, and growth here, it means exactly the rise in production level in economy, or rising GDP, gross domestic product. So in this chapter, we will see different determinants of the growth, which defines the growth, such as national income, GDP, GNP is what, NDP is what, NNP is what, and personal income is what. So different determinants of this income measurement or the growth measurement, we will discuss in this chapter. Again, we'll discuss this, how this economic growth is in conflict with this idea of economic development, and how they are related or interrelated with each other. Again, there are different measures for economic development, or there are different indexes which has been devised to measure this economic development. We will discuss again. We will discuss this development at the India level, and as well as the international, in the terms of sustainable development goal. And before this, it was millennium development goal. Fine. So all we will study in this chapter, growth and development. So next, the next chapter we will discuss in this inflation. Okay, the inflation aspect we will discuss in this chapter. Inflation is something which is rise in the price level in the economy. Okay, so this is measured. Inflation is very important aspect in the management of monetary matter or the money supply in India, and mainly this money supply or this monetary management lies in the hand of RBI. But this monetary management, that is all about managing the supply of the money in the economy. Fine. So this money supply is not only a monetary not only is having a monetary repercussion, it's also having a what? A repercussion is in other growth and development aspect of India. So how this fiscal and monetary management authority do this trade-off with respect to it? Okay. So in this chapter, we will discuss all those inflation, what are the different types of inflation, and what are this important instrument through which we can measure this inflation in India, or how this inflation is measured in India. There's this different CPI, consumer price index, wholesale price index, GDP deflator, inflation rate. This we will discuss on this. Again, we'll discuss many some inflation, cost plus inflation, okay, demand inflation, deflation, disinflation. These are interrelated terms which are mostly used with respect to the inflation. Again, this monetary, who said this monetary targeting India? What are the main bodies exactly other than this? Okay, Monetary Policy Committee, what is this? Inflation targeting is there. Fine. And what are these different tools of this monetary management used by the RBI, such as repo rate, reverse repo rate, fine, bank rate. Okay. So these are exactly the instrument through which, so we have a class. Isha, are you listening to me? Because this is orientation classes and I have students, are you listening to me, Isha? Can you type it? So I'm discussing about this, what is this whole role of this economic subject in this scheme of UPSC preparation, or this scheme of this whole preparation of this exam. So economy, come on Isha, please ask a question. You have raised the hand.
Hello.
Yes, I'm listening to you, please.
Yes sir.
Yes sir, ma'am, bataiye please, kya bol rahi hain?
Nothing sir.
Nothing. Okay, fine. Are you connecting with me? Because I'm just like, this lecture has become very much inanimated. Okay, nothing is just before me. I'm just like speaking while. So okay, this is much. You have like stay tuned with me. Okay, so I'm trying to discuss is what exactly this economy. Okay, this economy or economics. For overall this preparation, and this economy just lies is very important part of this prelims preparation, and this is also an important one for the mains. Fine. And this is exactly what this economy lies in this GS, which part of the GS? GS3. Fine. In the GS3, there are multiple topics or the subtopics have been given in the syllabus of UPSC, and also have given you this word for your kind form is the last year of more than 40 question or 13 more than 10 question have been asked from this economy section. So to score this economy is very much easy. There's a bit of objectivity is there. If you are sure and you have hand on this, all this economic principle and this terms, this becomes very much easy for you. So to obtain this marks in economy paper is very much easy, as well as it also gives you a good marks in mains. Fine. So we will discussing this from this whole different topics or the subtopics which is mentioned in a economy. That's okay, fine. So we started with planning. Okay, so our first chapter will start with this planning. So exactly before independence, India was having what? It was being ruled by the British. So British did nothing in order to develop this economy. Fine, all these sectors such as primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sectors, okay, this have been neglected by the British. After this British, exactly there's a bare minimum left in the hand of our policy maker, and from this stage they had started this idea of planning, and mostly this idea of planning has been derived from which? This has been derived from USSR. Find it. So we, in order to develop our economy from this brink, we initiated this policy of mixed economy. Fine. And this mixed economy where private player and the public player will go hand in hand, but in this whole setup, this public players or this the government would be having a commanding role in management of the economy. So this started with the LIF planning. So we'll discuss what is exactly the planning, different kind of plans, Bombay plan, okay, Bombay plan, Mahabali's plan, other different kind of plan which has been initiated, and again different 5 years plan, first 5 years, second plan, until 12 5 year, okay, and what are the different goals, targets, and what has been achieved in this. So this is a very important one. So we'll discuss this planning, and from this planning we will shift to this growth and development. Fine. So we will here we will study this aspect of the growth, what is exactly does it mean growth? So because the, as in a normal press, growth is something which is increasing. If you observe anything which is increasing, that is considered with the growth. So here in economy, in this chapter, the growth exactly it means the what? Here the growth means the economic growth. Economic growth means the growth in GDP, gross domestic product. Fine. So there are different measurement or different determinants of this growth. What is this GDP? What is this GNP? And what is this further NNP, NDP? Further, so what is this personal income? And how this is done and how this is being calculated? This is all studied in this growth and development. Again, this is what is the relation between growth and development? Fine. Because growth is different from development. Development is what? Something growth with parity. For example, if a country has increases production or means GDP is growing, this fruit of growing of the GDP should reach to each and every section of the society who are at the bottom. So we'll study in this growth and development part. Fine. So again, from this line, same, we'll try to delve into this idea of what is this idea of sustainable development growth and the sustainable development, what about say is different determinant or action, the factor will decide this. Find it. So from this, we will lead to the chapter third, that is inflation. So inflation aspect we will study in this economy. This is important for both prelims and mains. So what is this inflation? Inflation is something which is rise in the price level in the economy. So we'll study this inflation. What are the different instruments to measure this inflation? For example, WPI, wholesale price index, consumer price index, inflation deflators. Okay, so different index has been, we'll study all other parts of prelims. Okay, fine. Again, this inflation is managed by which authority and what is this exactly? This will lead to this idea of monetary policy in India. So this monetary policy exactly, again, what is this monetary policy? How it started from this? Who said this monetary policy? And what is again this idea of inflation targeting? What is this money supply, different kinds of money supply? Okay, how this is managed by the economy? We will all study in this economy chapter on this monetary policy in India. Fine. So this issue again, from this fifth chapter on this economy which you have to study, I'm just breaking up the syllabus. Fine. So this, are you guys will attain the class on only on this online mode or the offline mode? Will you come online or the offline? Isha and
yes sir.
Okay, you'll come the offline. Okay, today why you did, you guys didn't come? Ask Julia and upload.
सर मैं तो सिर्फ ऑनलाइन ही अटेंड करती
हूँ. अच्छा, आप ऑनलाइन ही अटेंड करोगे. फाइन. आपने और ये अदर पर्सन रिनू. ओके, आर यू लिसनिंग मी गाइस? फाइन. सो नाउ ऑन दिस, अगेन ऑन दिस बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल market we will discuss. So this definition of this, what is exactly the bank, what constitutes this bank, different types of banks, scheduled banks, regional rural development bank, different type of development banks, okay, different mortgage banks, multiple kinds of this terminologies or the terms we will discuss in this function, types of the bank, and also this history of this developed banking in India, started from this nationalization of this banking, again second nation is now this being happening. Okay, so we'll study many of this institution in this, because many of the same question from this UPSC directly asked from such institutions, the role of this they play into this. Fine. ICICI, ZB, again nationalization of the bank, again we'll study this banking sector reforms. Here we'll study mainly Narasimhan committee, Nachiketa Mor committee and PJ Naik committee. Such committees, in fact, this is also important for the prelims as well as for the mains examination. Fine. Again, this will study because of this banking sector is very much inflected from this very much burgeoning size of this NPA, non-performing assets. So what is this non-performing assets? What is this different categorization of this non-PA given by the RBI? And what is the whole implication of this NPA on overall credit and financial structure in India? And the ultimately how it play in the role of development with respect to the Indian economy. Fine. Again, we'll study the what is this NBFCs, because in the same time we have seen rises in this sprouting out this NBFCs in India. Many of these non-banking financial companies also recently a scam have been happening in this realm. So it has become very much important, NBFC, non-banking financial companies. So we'll study what are this non-banking financial companies, what is its role, and ultimately we will hit this idea, it is mostly of this means financial inclusion. What is this financial inclusion exactly? What is exactly this meaning or this terms exactly says you about? What are different types of financial inclusion? How this financial inclusion? What is this government policy for this financial inclusion? So all this study in this whole chapter of banking and financial institutions. Fine. Again, chapter 6, we come to this Indian agriculture. This is again very much important issues because India, what happened with the Indian economy, as we have seen, there's a, what is this pattern of development in any economy which is developing, for example, from the least development to developing to this developed stage, they have followed this path. So from this development, exactly what happened, this agriculture, the size of agriculture in terms of GDP contribution and in terms of this employment share decreases with increasing the development in a particular country. For example, take the case of US, their size when they have before this, the development of it, their size of their agriculture sector in terms of the GDP was very much. In fact, contributed to the development of the American economy. Fine. But with this time of time, there are decline in their GDP contribution and employment share also. So this development exactly the path which any country follows. That is from agriculture-led economy to the economy which is led more by the tertiary and industrial sector. Fine. So this sector exactly has got in the terms of India, this has been distorted. Okay. So we will study all these aspects. So Indian agriculture is very much important issue because most of this poverty, most of the situation of landlessness, in fact, this urban poor phenomena, which is also coming from this whole idea of the growth, or this would say this stagnation of agriculture sector. So agriculture sector for the policy maker and for our politician is very much important, and this is also for important for your UPSC preparation. So here we will study this agriculture. So we'll study this historical background, what is this current status, again multiple reforms we have seen, this land reform. So what is this land reform, what it has exactly bore the fruit, or it has given some negative consequence. Again, this different cropping pot pattern, we will discuss what are different cropping pattern. And again, this whole agriculture, this system of MSP, PDS system. Okay, so all we will discuss in this agriculture. So this is very much important aspect because agriculture pricing in India is very much a controversial issue. So this is also has some socio-political nature. So we will discuss all this in this Indian agriculture. Fine. Again, we see this agriculture, this is a very big one. In fact, the big chapter is, so we will study this issue with related to subsidy in India, because subsidy is given by the, this has been the policy since starting from Indian government to provide subsidy to agriculture and to the other services in terms of providing this basic communities, government provides subsidy. So what is this exactly the meaning of the subsidy? What is the rationale of subsidy? Why subsidy is being given or why it is not being given? Why the subsidy? So are positive and negative and different kinds of subsidy. Again, different minimum support price. We have saying public distribution. What is this public? Again, this important, we'll discuss this agriculture marketing. In this agriculture marketing, this is very important, or the burning issues. Agriculture, so the government has passed this model APMC Act, but many of the state haven't followed it. And recently, in this government also for this very purpose has initiated a bill or has been made an act, but because of this farmer protest, this has been taken away by the government. This act has been withdrawn by the government. So we'll discuss the whole issue of the, what is the issue with this agriculture market, where there is a problem and what could be the solution of it. Fine. And again, many of this schemes or mission related to farmers, we will study these chapters. Again, this chapter 7 exactly, we will discuss this poverty, inequality and unemployment. Okay, this is also an important chapter or the subtopics. We will study this poverty in India, what is this types of the poverty in India, how this poverty line is determined in India, and how this, what is the lacuna or overall the sad shortcomings in deciding this whole poverty line. So this is cows vicious cycle of the poverty. What is this poverty line, estimation of different community, we will studies. Okay, again we will come into this idea of inclusive growth. Fine. And how it, this poverty leads to this idea of inequality, this definition, and how this inequality is different from marginalization and other terms. Okay. And again we'll study this unemployment. What is this definition of unemployment in India? find what is this different types of unemployment, what is the measurement the government takes, and again the jobless growth. This is an important issue in India, so we will discuss this is jobless growth. We only discuss with respect to the development, because this growth without employment generation is called jobless growth. The growth should be what? It should also generate unemployment, and this exactly tells you the idea of development. So we'll study this development. Fine. Again, other important animal ranges we will study under this agriculture. Fine. Again, guys, government budget. This important discusses how the government prepare the budget for this exam, for this Indian economy and this whole fiscal matters. What is this fiscal deficit? What is this revenue deficit? Or this related terms we will discuss in this is getting one point. And again, what is this idea of fiscal deficit lead to? Why it is a problem in nature? Fine. So all these benefits will study. Again, we'll discuss this taxation. Taxation in India is done by the government. What is different kind of taxes, direct and indirect? What is the benefit and shortcomings of each of them? And again, what is this GST? What is own exactly the implication of the GST? We will try to evaluate this GST. Again, different tax reform, which is underlying one hat has been completed, which is GST, but still the direct tax code, which has not been implemented yet. So we will also discuss this direct tax code under this. Okay, and again, different taxes related terms we will study under this, such as tax incidence, tax evasion, Laffer curve, cess, and surcharge. So all these are very important for this fiscal matter, or this government budgeting is very much important topic. Okay, for the prelims as well as for the mains. Fine. Are you listening, my guys? Because I feel unconnected, because I'm just like speaking. Are you getting what I'm telling to you? This is not a starting of this economic session. Okay, this is very much, I mean, in animated kind of thing, just like discussing these all are the chapters we will discuss in our subsequent lectures. So we'll start from this planning, and later on, and from this manner, we will study each one of these chapters. Okay, so each one of this like very important. You have, if like you have to get analysis of the snapshot of it, you go and make analysis of this previous year question. Every time you will see more than 10 questions have been asked from this economic session, and most of them you will see are related to the concept or the principle or the term of the economy. So if you have hand on this, all these terms are related. So this papers is what is very much predictable and very much marks fetching. Fine. So this we will study. So now will this taxation in India. So we'll have to discuss all these aspects, topics, and the subtopics. Fine. So this in this external sectors, we'll see in this external sector, we will discuss different kind of foreign exchange, how this foreign exchange is maintained, how this is exactly the price of particular currency vis-a-vis the currency of the world increases or decreases, what is the whole repercussion of the whole exercise, and how this external exactly the here we will discuss this balance of payment, as India has seen a balance of payment crisis during just 1991 LPG crisis. Fine. So this, what is this BOP, what is this component, and what is this current account deficit, what is this capital account deficit, what is this exactly the whole things, current account deficit, and different committees, there are four committees into this, capital account convertibility, current account convertibility, these all the topics we will discuss under this external sector. How this foreign exchange is decided, we will study. How does this FDI policies there, how does the FIs is different, we'll all study on this foreign, how this foreign rate is exchanged under this. Also, we'll discuss in this chapter. Fine. Again, this chapter 11 will discuss the Indian International Economic Organization, because in all of this paper, we have seen one or two questions have been asked solely from this International Economic Organization. So here we'll study this starting of Bretton Woods, and this lead to the formation of two bodies in the world, World Bank and IMF, other different alternative Asian Development Bank. The BRICS Bank is in the news, so it is very much important. Okay, so this we will study again, bilateral and regional global grouping, different grouping, World Trade Organization, what is this World Organization and this relation with the India with respect to the agriculture commodity and other trade related issue we will discuss in this International Economic Organization. Fine. अगेन चैप्टर 12, दिस इज मोस्टली फॉर द मेंस. दिस चैप्टर 12 वी विल डिस्कस दिस फूड प्रोसेसिंग एंड रिलेटेड इंडस्ट्री. व्हाट इज दिस फूड प्रोसेसिंग एग्जैक्टली एंड हाउ इट ऑफर्स एज अ अल्टरनेटिव मीडियम फॉर इंडियन फार्मर्स टू हैव अ more income. So what is the status, definition, different dimension of food processing industry, its backward and forward linkages, different how this is, we will study in this whole food process. Okay, fine. So we'll study in this, and what is different FDI policy of the government, what is the supply chain management is overall, because this supply chain management is very burning issue, because after this COVID the world has seen the disruption in this supply chain, the world supply chain. Now this world comes to the news of new world, resilience of supply chain. So we'll study this, what is exactly this terms is all about, this resilience or supply chain resilience is all about, what exactly, what is the implication, limitation, how it should be. Okay, so we'll study all these chapters. Fine. And the next Chapter 3, that is industrial sector. So what does this industrial development mean to India? Different industrial policy I have seen. Public sector is what exactly? Privatization of the public sector is what exactly? Here we'll study the disinvestment policy and mainly those policy of the government. Right? Again, the chapter 14, we'll study this under this infrastructure. What is the definition of the infrastructure? What are the different types of the infrastructure? And what is the status of different infrastructure in India? And what are the shortcomings related to each one of them? And what could be done on the policy matter from this government perspective? Fine. Again, and this last chapter, we will study this investment model. How this investment model works, example, many of this government works or the policy is done on this basis of PPP, purchase prime. Okay, PPP is what exactly? Public private partnership. Fine. So we'll study this different model of this public private built annuity model, okay, build operate model. This all model we will study under this hybrid annuity model. So its challenges of the model. So all study under this chapter, and after this we'll have this discussion of on, and each of these topics involves this question discussion on prelims as well as on the mains, which has been in the prelims examination or in main examination. Fine. Also we'll focus more on this answer writing aspect. Okay, fine. So every time 7, 8, 9 questions from this economic part will be asked in a mains examination. So this paper is very much important for the prelims as well as for the mains. Fine. So these are the overall the chapter discussion with respect to it. We will study what we will study in this whole economic class. Okay, where we have only two guys right now, Isha and Karan. Why the next name is not visible to me is because I have Aisha. So fine guys, so you guys have any problem with respect to this, so I want to respond it, because I have explained it. This is not a much economics. We will start of this core economics or this economic from the next class. Today is only for the orientation. So I want to bridge this gap, as I have discussed a lot. I have told you many of these things, this discussion, how this, you can ask me different questions with respect to your queries. You have anything with respect to this economic subject or the overall scheme of the examination, what should be done or what should not be done by. Okay. So anybody have any questions, please, Isha and Kusu, please clear your doubt. I'll just open to you. Are you listening, guys?
Yes. So
anything you wanted to know from me? You have any doubt, Isha?
No, sir. It was quite clear. This is it.
Okay. This is like, I have given you this usability of the paper. Okay. This paper offers you a lot. Offers you a lot in terms of what? In terms of this prelims scheme and in terms of this mains scheme. Okay. If you go and analyze, and what is very important to, if you are preparing for any of the examination, first you have to see the syllabus as well as you have to see the PYQ, the previous year question have been asked. So if you see, if you make analysis of it, you see every year in the prelims, you will find more than 10 questions or close to 10 have been asked from this prelims. And this exactly, this economic subject exactly is what more of this subjective in nature. Okay, if you have like understood this concept and principle, so this question exactly, out of you will attempt 10 questions, you will correct almost 8 to 9 questions. Fine. एंड दिस जस्ट यू हैव टू इसमें कि सर स्टडी मटेरियल क्या होगा तो अभी आई वोंट सजेस्ट एनी ऑफ दिस बुक जस्ट यू हैव टू गो बाय माय लेक्चर्स पॉइंट व्हाट आई हैव मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड हियर ऑल दोस कॉन्सेप्ट आई विल डिक्टेट यू मेनी ऑफ दिस पॉइंट सो दिस माय क्लास लेक्चर इज इनफ फॉर यू ओके फॉर दिस इकोनॉमिक्स माय क्लास लेक्चर इज इनफ what concept I have made you write just you have to speak up okay so we'll discuss here all in this and other than my class notes you have to just refer this current affairs because in economics most of this question have been asked exactly from the current affairs but this current affairs is not only a current affairs only or not only the fact okay this is linked with this conceptual part of this and this conceptual part we'll study in this economics okay which I'll teach you fine so this chapter is very much objective in nature and this is very much hand in both the limbs as well as for the means so is there anything other than this hello
no sir fine
okay fine anything you wanted to ask any question from me ki sir ye mujhe samajh nahi aa raha hai ki kya please ask Karhenuo, the second person here in this voice from the behind Isha are you at somewhere I mean Karhenuo so this Karhenuo are you getting my point buddy if you have any doubts with respect to it we'll start from this okay this chapter and this examination is what exactly this is the you have a given syllabus just go through and just before coming to the class just go through the syllabus what are those syllabus in because this is very much important if I say for this for any of this examination you should be having two anchor with you all the or the torch this is what exactly the PYQ and the PYQ that is previous year question in the syllabus gives you the what exactly the boundary of this subject from which area the question would be asked because this is necessary to know which part I have to study and which not fine not everything is important this will give you take an idea from this syllabus okay so get a full idea of the syllabus and knowing the syllabus is also helpful so that this examination is a very much active kind of preparation where you can learn not only by sitting in the class or by attending my lecture you also get idea from this outside because this overall your daily life or the life you exactly okay and they are surrounded by many of this economic social or this many of this interaction which is happening in the society you should be having this practical knowledge of the economy how things is being done how this government every time you will see in this the Hindu newspaper or any other newspaper economic session any time for example the RBI increases this repo rate or the reverse repo rate so what is this meaning overall or how it does play its role in terms of managing of this money supply in India or overall for the economy. Many of this time governments have brought new fiscal policy and what exactly this means of exact terms like that. So this paper or overall for this examination is very much practical in nature. So you have to be very much this idea of syllabus in your mind. Okay. As well, after this syllabus, this subject is not solely studied in the UPSC preparation. Economics also is a academic subject. Fine. So this is also taught in school and colleges. So, but what is the difference then between this, what is being taught or what is being asked in a UPSC examination and colleges? So this the difference is because of this tone and temperament of the question. Okay, the tone and temperament of the question is bit different. Fine. So what is asked here? So if you make analysis of this previous year question, we'll get to know okay, what are these important areas or exactly from that particular area how the question is being asked by the UPSC. And this is very much important to know the scheme of the exam because har kuch nahi pad sakte. This examination is what? There are two things of this examination. Okay, this is one of the most complex examination as the one argument I say, and this is also one of the most. In fact, one of those like simple things is not like one is this complex part of this examination is about the size of the syllabus. It is a very humongous size. Okay, mammoth in size, Himalayan in nature, exactly. If I say. So if, for example, ek padhoge dusra chutega and start from this one, you will leave another thing. So exactly this to manage this whole syllabus of big size of has become very much complex. Otherwise, the simplest part of this examination is what each and every topic is very much simple. दिस इज नॉट अ रॉकेट साइंस. ओके, अगर एक बार में समझ नहीं आता तो वंस ट्वाइस थ्राइस ओके यू विल गेट टू नो द आइडिया कि व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दिस इज ऑल अबाउट. दिस इम्प्लीमेंटेशन पार्ट, दिस होल problem lies with this implementation. What I'm telling you, I'll give you this suggestion, don't be guided by anybody's whatever says other says to you. Okay, just follow what I'm giving to you. Okay, and this you will get a marks in an examination. That is a funda. This is a simple funda. So you have understood this, guys?
Fine.
Okay, so it's better not to, I mean, magaba, I don't have much things to tell you, like I have discussed the syllabus from this. Next time we will discuss, okay, the very first chapter from this planning we will start. Okay, so and from this, and if you have sure. any of this issue, so please you may ask, otherwise I'll end this lecture. Isha, are you listening to me?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So should I finish this?
Yes sir, sure.
Fine, sure, okay. Because I have nothing to tell. Kya batau tumko? We'll discuss when we'll study this. We'll try to give lectures on this. So each and every part, I'll bring you the specific or the particular strategy where we'll say how you have to proceed with this preparation of this economic and overall for the UPSC preparation, how you'll proceed, how you'll make the notes, and this trainee or trivial or micro matter we will discuss on this. Okay, fine. So thank you guys, both of you.